In this illustration, we are going to simulate the seepage in the soil underneath a concrete dam in the Abaqus software. Here, our model includes a concrete dam and soil, and the coefficient of permeability has also been defined for the soil. The height of water behind the dam is 12 meters, which you can observe in the picture. The simulation aims at drawing the flow net, and you can observe that in this picture. In the next picture, you'll observe the equipotential lines, and in the picture after that, the flow lines have been displayed. Actually, we intend to simulate the 9-9 example of Sam Halveni book in the Abaqus software. In this picture, the proportions of the dam and the soil, as well as the height of water behind the dam, can be observed. And the flow net having been drawn in Sam Halveni book can also be observed in this picture. I'll enter Abaqus software for simulation. Click on Create Part in Part Module. From here, I will select the modeling space as two-dimensional and of deformable type. From here, I'll select Shell and put the rough size of the tracing page as 1000. Then, I will draw a rectangle with a length of 420 meters, the height of 90 meters, and then I'll draw an initial schematic design of the dam. In this manner, I'll put the size of this side as 18 meters, this angle as 50 degrees, this angle as 50 degrees, then the length of distance as 180 meters, this one as 180 meters too, and this length of distance as 60 meters. And if you look at the picture in your book, you'll see the distances and sizes having been determined, in which the height is 90 meters, this length of distance 180 meters, this one 60 meters, and this one 180 meters. Now I'll remove this extra side or line using Auto Trim Tools and click on Done. Now we should create partition so we can separate the section of concrete dam from the soil. First, I'll draw a horizontal line from the Tools, Partition, Face, Sketch, Menu, and then click on Done. In this manner, our section was divided into two partitions, one of which is soil and the other one is concrete dam. I'll enter property module in order to define the properties of those materials. I'll click on create material. I intend to define properties of concrete, means those used for concrete dam, from this part. I'll select density of concrete as 2,300 kilogram per cubic meter, mechanical elasticity and elastic from the general density menu. Young module is put as 21 multiplied by 10 to the power of 9 Pascal, and Poisson ratio is 0.2, and OK. Again, I'll click on create material. Here I intend to define properties of soil. The density is 1,700 kg per cubic meter from the general density menu, from the mechanical menu elasticity and elastic, and the Young module is 68 multiplied by 10 to the power of 6 Pascal, and the Poisson ratio is 0.3. The coefficient of permeability is the most important point and also parameter which should be defined in this section. So I'll select pore fluid from the other menu. Here I'll select permeability, the quantity of which is K. And if we glance back in the book, K has been defined equal to 0.03 cubic meter per second. 0.03 multiplied by 10 to the power of a negative 2 meter per second. Void ratio is equal to 1. Here we should enter a specific weight of water, that is the multiplication result of water density multiplied by g, the quantity of which is equal to 9810. Here I'll click on OK. Now I should create the section, so I will click on Create Section, Soil, Solid, Homogeneous, Continue, and then select Oil Material and OK. Now I should create a section for the concrete. I'll select the concrete and OK. Now we should assign sections we have created to different sections, so I'll go to the assigned section, select soil and the soil section and OK. Here the concrete dam, concrete and OK. As you observe, since we have defined coefficient of permeability only for the soil, so we can calculate pore pressure only for the soil and consider seepage and permeability for it as well. But as we have not defined coefficient of permeability for the concrete dam, we cannot calculate parameters such as pore pressure and seepage in the dam. Here I will enter my own model into the assembly module, transfer that to this point and OK. Then I'll enter step module, click on create step. As you observe, we should use soils analysis in the questions in which subjects such as porosity of soil, coefficient of permeability, pore pressure, saturation, void ratio, flow lines, equipotential lines, phreatic surface flow of water speed in soil, and such materials as these are surveyed. Here, since we are not going to consider the remodelings, so we should put the analysis as linear means off. The time of analysis would be 1 second, and the analysis would be solved in form of steady state. The maximum number of increments is 100 and the initial increment size is 1 in the incrementation edge, and these parameters don't need to be remodeled. I'll take this option off, and here also no remodeling is needed to be applied, and so OK. I will enter load module. There is no systematic order in the interaction module, so I will enter load module directly. Click on create boundary condition. Here, step, initial displacement, rotation, and continue. I'll select the whole model. We'll close the U1, U2 degree because we don't intend to calculate the remodelings. Then click on create boundary condition. Here we intend to apply boundary condition for the pore pressure. From here, I'll select step 1, other, pore pressure, and if I glance back in the book, you'll observe that since the height of water behind the dam is 12 meters in this section, and the pore pressure is equal to 117.7 kilopascal, and this quantity has been calculated as the following formula. Rho GH, rho is actually water density, G the gravitational acceleration, and H is the height. And if we calculate the quantity, it will be equal to 117.7 kilopascal. And as you observe here, the height of water behind the dam is 12 meters. Now I'll select pore pressure from here. First the surface and then the quantity, which had been calculated as 117.7 multiplied by 10 to the power of 3 Pascal. Another boundary condition is on this side where the pore pressure is 0. I'll put its quantity as 0. As well, and OK. As you observe in the picture, this section is an impermeable surface, and the surface underneath the concrete is also impermeable, that is here, so it means this is impermeable too. The next main point is entering the weight of soil and concrete dam altogether. I'll click on create load. Here the body force. Since our model becomes complete in this part, we should use body force in order to apply the specific weight of the soil. So I'll select the soil and enter a specific weight that will be negative 7,000. Then I will click on create load again. From here, body force and the specific weight of concrete that will be equal to negative 23,000, which I will enter that in this manner. In the next step, I should define the initial void ratio for the soil. I will select create, predefined field, initial other, void ratio, continue, select the soil and consider the initial void ratio as 1 for that. I will enter mesh module, parts, then I will put the size for the granulation as 5 meters and OK. Then I click on assign mesh control, select the concrete dam, then sweep, coat and OK, select the soil in form of coat, structured and OK. Then I click on mesh part and meshing will be completed in this manner. After that, click on assign element type and select the soil. The element family should be set on pore fluid stress, and actually a P letter will be added to the end of the element noun, and these elements will be capable of calculating pore pressure, and you can observe here. We won't need to make any specific adjustment. I'll directly enter the job module. Here, first we intend to draw equipotential lines, so we continue, OK, and I will click on submit. Our analysis was done successfully, so I will click on result, and here on pore pressure, here we first intend to draw equipotential lines. Now I should first remove meshing so we can have a better shape of our model graphically. Then I will put contour type on isosurface from this part in this manner. After that, I intend to whiten the background from the view and graphic option menu in this manner to make it more clear. Now we can modify its adjustments in this way. As you see, the results we gained, and those in here can be observed quite well. Then I'll return to the assembly module. Here I intend to draw the flow lines. I'll enter from the load module from this part and change the boundary conditions in such a manner that I would transfer the section where the pore pressure was equal to 117,700 Pascal to this end, means the bottom, and here the pore pressure would be equal to 117,000. Then I will come to the section where the pore pressure is 0 and transfer that to the underneath of the concrete dam in this manner. Now the pore pressure in this section became equal to 0 and no further changes is required, so I'll click on the job. Here we intend to draw the flow lines. I'll choose a proper name, flow lines, and run that accordingly. Now, as you observe in the picture, the lines I'm pointing at with the mouse and are in form of semicircle should be drawn completely so we can get the result. The analysis was done successfully. I click on result. From here, I click on pore pressure. So we can gain the results which are actually the same flow lines, and can be observed. Now, should you like to observe both results in one page simultaneously, you should click on Viewport, Create, then modify that into horizontal form from here. As you see in both of the samples, the upper section is related to flow lines and the bottom section is related to equipotential lines. And if I select this section now, you will observe you will observe how the results will be gained.